Hello students, welcome to today's class. Today's lesson is on simple machine and we would be learning about levers and class inclined planes. And at the end of today's lesson, our objectives are to be able to define simple machine, give the types of machines we have and their examples, should be able to define lever and give three classes of lever with their arrangement, and we should be able to give the examples of each classes of lever that we have. Now, what is a machine? It is any arrangement that enables us to do work more easily and conveniently. That is, machines enable us to do things that we could not do with our unaided strength. We have some examples of simple machines in our home, and they are brooms, spoons, knives, hoes, etc. And we have two types of machines. We have the simple machine and the complex machine. The simple machines are machines that are not confined to industries and workshops, but they are commonly found in the homes and offices, e.g. knives, or cutlass, wheelbarrows, brooms, hammer, etc. And we have the complex machines. They are machines that are made up of two or more simple machines, which depend on one another to function. They look complicated because they are big and they have lots of parts, and they are majorly confined to workshops and industries. And examples of these types of complex machines are printers, motor cars, engines, tractors, etc. Now, what is a lever? A lever is one of the simplest and efficient machines for lifting loads and producing a great work. It is also any rigid body which is pivoted about 5 points, called the fulcrum. And on this body is applied a force called effort, which overcomes another force called load. We mentioned sometimes earlier about lever, which we must understand. That is, the force applied called effort, the object being lifted called load, and the point of printing called fulcrum. The arrangement of this effort, load, and fulcrum determine the classes a lever belongs to. And there are three classes of lever, namely the first class lever, the second class lever, and the third class lever. The first class lever is the class of lever which the fulcrum is between the load and effort. And examples are our scissors, pliers, screwdrivers, etc. The second class lever is the class of lever where the load is between the fulcrum and the effort. And the third class lever is a class of lever where the effort is between the load and the fulcrum. Example is table knife, cutlass, test tube holder, etc. Now, what is force ratio? The term force ratio is defined as the ratio of way to effort, as the ratio of work to effort, load over effort. That is, when a small force is applied to produce a large one, then the force ratio, which is greater than 1, is called a mechanical advantage. But when the large effort applied is less than 1, it is called a mechanical disadvantage. So we have come to the end of today's lesson, and I am sure we can now define machines. We can define the simple and the complex machine, and we can give these classes of levers that we have and their examples. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you in the next class. Thank you.